Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Have you seen a soccer team that doesn't do any training at all? Praise the Lord. No training at all. And they go play. You think success is guaranteed? Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Amen. So this is training. Amen. This is training. If you want to be a successful, you know, soccer team, successful, whatever you do in life, yeah? Even marriage, if you want to have a successful marriage, you got to go through training. Praise the Lord. Amen. Amen. Same thing with the Christian life. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Christian life, we go through training. Praise the Lord. So that we can be successful Christians and do the things that God is asking us to do. Amen. Amen. Hallelujah. God is not going to allow us to go through the Christian life without any training whatsoever. No way. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Amen. So you're most welcome. Praise the Lord. So that's the reason why you see some of the stuff that we deal with in this teaching is both cascades. Yeah. Because some people are not used to discipline and correction. Amen. They're not used to it. Praise the Lord. But you see in this church, I didn't know how to say it, but you see in this church, Pastor, we're going through a phase now. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. There's a change in the culture of the way we do worship in this church right now. I'm saying it right now. I don't know whether it's a prophetic statement or not, but I'm saying it. You notice that God cannot give us new wine unless the wineskin is changed. And that's why God is dealing with the vessel that you and me, with the vessel. We cannot contain the power of God and go to a higher level in God if we are not willing to be corrected or changed. Can the church say amen?
Amen.
That's why this kind of training is cascades. Praise the Lord. Cascades to the pastor doing the teaching and cascades to the people sitting down there taking it on board. Both ways. It goes both ways. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Because I've got to deal with demons when they're trying to come and stop me from teaching the church. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. And also the criticism for the people who are not happy about them being taught and corrected. Amen. Keep saying amen. Amen. Hallelujah. So you see, we're dealing with the power of praise and worship. We started the other night. Amen. Hallelujah. We found out that there is power in worship. Amen. Worship is a weapon. It is a weapon of warfare. Praise the Lord. So we've got to learn not only to sing in church, but also sing when we are facing problems, situations, calamities. Learn to sing in sickness. Learn to praise God and worship God when we're going through difficult times. Amen. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Amen. The weapons of praise and worship. We learned last night about the three Hebrew words for worship. So God is seeking people, believers, who will worship Him in spirit and in truth. And it's impossible to worship Parameshwar in spirit and in truth unless, number one, we are filled with the Holy Spirit.
Hallelujah.
Amen?
Amen.
Praise the Lord. That's why we said last night, if you're not filled with the Holy Spirit, please don't take part up here until you've been filled.
Hallelujah.
Amen?
Amen.
Get filled first, then come up here. Gifts, talents, and abilities, how much do they carry?
5%.
5%. Amen? So what are we relying on? Praise the Lord. Amen. If we're not filled with the Holy Spirit. If we're not filled with the Holy Spirit, and our gifts, talents, and abilities is only 5%, the rest of that, the 95%, what are we relying and depending on? On our experience, praise the Lord, we rely on our experience, on our knowledge, and the very thing that Proverbs chapter 3 forbids us to do. The Bible in Proverbs chapter 3 verses 5 and 6 says, trust in the Lord and lean not, do not depend on it, do not trust it. Lean not to your own understanding, but in all your ways acknowledge Him, and He will direct your paths. That's why we need to be filled with the Holy Spirit. Amen. We found out, eh? Even Jesus told the disciples that one of the conditions was before they go out and do the Great Commission was to be what? Filled with the Holy Spirit. Tarry. The word wait, tarry. Yeah? Wait in Jerusalem, tarry in the upper room, and then when you get filled with the Holy Ghost, then go and do evangelism. Praise the Lord. Yeah? That's why this thing is about catch, yeah? Yeah. Because we're going through a new phase in this church. Praise the Lord. The Bible says in the book of Peter, judgment begins in the house of the Lord. Doesn't begin with the wicked, begins with us. Amen? Praise the Lord. If God's people are not disciplined enough to worship Parameshwar in the correct way that Parameshwar has designed to be worshipped, eh, those people will never learn anything. Praise the Lord. Amen? So if we cannot bring ourselves down, humble ourselves, and come under the teaching, eh, that's being applied in the church, man, no matter where we go, we will never learn anything. We think we can go to a church and just do whatever we want to. And sooner or later, Parameshwar is going to have to deal with us. I mentioned about the four options. Keep that preaching, eh, constantly in your mind. Praise the Lord. So worship is a deeper form of praise. Everyone can praise God, eh? But not everyone can truly worship when you worship every part of you is involved. Your mind, your body, and your spirit. This is what happened. Yeah? And that's what we want. Eh? We want the whole of us to engage in worship. Amen. Engage in worship. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. So we need to tune our spirit in to the wavelength and the frequency of the Holy Spirit so we can catch what the Holy Spirit is saying. Praise the Lord. We touched a little bit last night on the practical things. We will be going through a little bit deeper. How many of you like the practical stuff we teach last night? Praise the Lord. Amen?
Amen.
You get personal with God. This is what worship does. Amen. You get worship, you know, you get personal with God and you forget about the person sitting next to you. Because now it's heart to heart engagement. Amen. Spirit to spirit engagement. Holy Spirit in you and Father. Because eh, God is the Spirit. Amen. Praise the Lord. So it's spirit to spirit engagement. Heart to heart engagement. That is worship. Praise the Lord. Amen. Hallelujah. Yeah? So we come from the outer court to the Holy of Holies, where you physically, spiritually prostrate before God. You remember the tabernacle we were dealing with the other day? The other week? Praise the Lord. So for the purpose of this article, we will be interchanging these two words, praise and worship, and use them together. Amen. Just how powerful is praise and worship? Worship pulls down the glory of God. Understand that. Amen. Worship pulls down or draws the presence of God. Amen. Amen. Because what happens in worship, you notice, we are creating an atmosphere conducive to the presence of God. Watch. See, if God is not honored, then God cannot come down in that service. Yeah? So when the presence of God is here, learn to honor and respect that presence. That's why I came down very strongly last week about the cup of tea being served. Amen? That's why I came down very strongly. Because it's very, very expensive to create the atmosphere conducive to the presence of God. When it's here, man, learn to respect it. Learn to honor it. Amen? Praise the Lord. You notice if you've been in a service where the presence of God is not there, man, the service is dry. very dry. Amen. The preacher is working overtime. Yeah? Hallelujah. Trying to get, praise the Lord. He's preaching the gospel by faith now. Amen. But when the presence is there, when everything clicks in, everything falls into place. There's a saying in sports, they say, you're in the zone. Okay? So when we're in the zone, the spiritual zone of the Holy Ghost, everything just flows. Word of knowledge come out. Prophetic words come out. Amen? Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Anybody want to say something about you being in the zone? Or you being in a service where everything was in the zone, everything just clicks. Amen? Just flows. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. When you worship God, the Bible says He inhabits the praises of His people, or He sits enthroned on the praises of His people. What this means is that when you start to praise God, He comes down in your midst and inhabits your praise. This is why, for all of us who are involved in some kind of ministry in the church, in the life of the church, okay? Hallelujah. We take time during the week to prepare ourselves for that. I said it last night. You know, if you can't go to the throne during the week, how are you going to lead the church and take them to the throne? Amen?
Yeah.
If you haven't been to the throne during the week, how are you going to lead the church to go to the throne? Praise the Lord. So you need to be spending time during the week in the presence of God, soaking in it, immerse yourself in it, swim in it. Amen? Swim in it. Praise the Lord. So when you come in the church to do whatever you do for Parameshwar in the church, praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Everything flows. Can I just add on? Please don't look for notoriety, no self-promotion in the church. Eh? Don't think for 1 minute, I'm going to do this, and pastor going to notice it, and I'm going to get a promotion. Don't do that. No self-promotion. Amen? Whatever has been entrusted to you to do, whether you're the cleaner, the caretaker, whatever, how small, how minuscule, how little it is, do it unto the Lord. Don't do it to the pastor. Whether the pastor recognizes it or not, don't worry about it, because you're not doing it to Him, you're doing it to Parameshwar. Amen.
Amen?
Because we don't expect us to notice everything. Hallelujah. Because some people's attitude is like that, eh? I'll do this, I'll do that, I'll do this, I'll do that, and therefore, you know, pastor will let people preach from the top. Pastor will give me a platform ministry. Don't do that. No sort of self-promotion. Amen. I know it's hard. Can you handle it? And the church say?
Amen.
God. Praise the Lord. Amen. God loves to be worshipped. Amen. In fact, that is one of the reasons you were created. We found that out last night, eh? Man was created to worship God. The whole reason you and I were put on this planet was to worship Parameshwar. Excuse me. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord, Sister Mary. I'm going to do it. However, for God to inhabit, or in order for our worship to pull down the glory of God, we must be one accord. We must be one accord. Amen. Hallelujah. Don't do anything that'll cause division in the church. Don't do anything that will cause division in the church. Keep the unity. Maintain the unity. Praise the Lord. God bless you. Amen?
Amen.
Don't be a troublemaker in the church. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. Our minds cannot be scattered, or everyone, or one or everyone doing their own thing. All of us must come together. I find this I find this regularly in Fiji, on my trip to Fiji, that, you know, somebody's got the gifting of intercession or prophecy or healing or evangelism. And what happens is that then they go and start their own ministry. Eh? Amen? They don't want to be inside the church. They just want to go do their own ministry so they can do their own thing. Eh? Understand, this is a warning. Understand one thing. The gifts of the Holy Spirit has been given to the church, yeah, for the edification of the church. Yeah? For the church. That's like, take your ear, and if your ear has got a gift of hearing, and if your ear just want to go and do their own thing, will this ear survive? No. You still need the rest of the body. The body doesn't function properly because one ear is missing. Praise the Lord. But the ear will die straight away. That's the thing, eh? The church is under an umbrella of protection. Everybody that comes in the church is under that umbrella of protection. The moment you shift out, yeah, you're on your own. And the devil gets you when you're out. The church is like a Noah's Ark. Imagine Noah's Ark, the boat. Remember that big boat? With all the animals. And only one window on top of it. Excuse me. With all the animals, can you imagine the smell in that boat? With all the animals in it. But here's the thing. Eh? Here's the thing. It's safer in the boat than outside the boat. Amen? Which one do you prefer? With the smelly animals or outside swimming? Yeah. Praise the Lord. Sometimes in church, with all the different personalities of all the people, there's clash of personality. Praise the Lord. That's to be expected. But it's better inside clashing, yeah, because we can be corrected, taught, listen, you know, just calm down a bit. Rather than be outside there drowning in the flood. Amen. Yeah. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Church is like that. Church life is like that. Hallelujah. We will have disagreements. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. And the pastors have to come and correct you. Hallelujah. You may not like it, but it's necessary for you to get along with other people. Praise the Lord. And mind you, there is no perfect church. If you're looking for the perfect church, when you find it, don't join it. Because if it's already perfect before you got there, it will be imperfect when you join. Because you're the one who's going to make it bad. Because they're already perfect. And you're not. And guess what? And none of us are perfect. God is still working with each and every one of us every day. Can you say amen?
Amen.
Praise the Lord. Amen. 2 Corinthians 5, 13 and 14. Can you read it for us? 2, 3. Praising and worshiping God. There's a spiritual cloud of God's presence that comes upon that worship. Amen?
Amen?
There's a spiritual cloud. Praise the Lord. So you see, when the cloud comes, praise the Lord, healing is available. Deliverance is available. Needs met. Praise the Lord. Yeah? Right there. Right there. Amen? Praise the Lord. There's a saying, there's a saying that says, when the pattern is right, the glory falls.
Amen.
When the pattern is right, the glory falls. Amen. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Amen. Notice why God could have come down in their midst was because they were all on one accord. One of the reasons we are not seeing many healing prophecies and deliverance in the churches today is because we're not in one accord. That's one. We're not in unity. That's one. The other one is Satan has corrupted our worship. We're singing demonic songs in the church and not our national songs. We're singing, we're singing the songs of Babylon instead of the songs of Zion. So, praise and worship team, pay very careful attention to the song selection that the God, the Holy Ghost, has led you to be sung on that Sunday morning or any service. Praise the Lord. You should be constantly seeking God during the week, asking Parameshwar, what kind of song do you want your people, not what you want to sing, but what you want your people to sing, to worship and praise you. And Parameshwar will say it. Amen? Hallelujah. It's like Pastor Akish and myself and me. We don't come here and preach anything we want to because we don't work for you. We work for him. We go to him and ask him, what do you want to say to your people on Sunday? Then he gives the message, then we can preach it. If you don't like it, if you hate it, that's your problem. You have to deal with him. We're only the messenger boy.
Hallelujah.
Amen? It's not our message. He gave the message. He gave the anointing. He gave the courage and the boldness to declare it. If you're not happy with it, go to him. We're only delivering what he gave us. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. That's like ringing pizza. Praise the Lord. You order the pizza and the delivery boy delivers it to you. If you're not happy with the pizza, can you shoot the delivery boy? No, you can't. He didn't cook it. He didn't make it. He only delivered it. Amen. Praise the Lord. Some people today in the church are shooting the pastors for delivering Parameshwar's message. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. God is a God of order. Here we go. God is a God of order. And so when his people gather together, he expects us to all be on one accord. God is God of order, and he wants things to be done in the correct order, the way he sets it. That's why I said it the other week. This is the standard. If it's not in here, we don't do it. If it's in here, we do it. Plain and simple. Amen? That's the standard. The Word of God is the standard. That's our standard. Not what other people, other churches do. What other people and other churches do, that's their business. But it is our business. I'm talking about the leadership here. It is our business what happens in this church. If there's any questions to be asked, Parameshwar will ask us. Not what other people do over there. Amen?
Amen.
Praise the Lord. I want you to further understand that when the glory of the Lord comes down in your midst, whatever is not right, he will start fixing it. Praise the Lord. Give me that. Huh? Amen? Whatever is not right, whatever is not right, he will fix it. Amen? Broken pieces will start to melt. Healing and deliverance will be administered, and the people will leave the house of God knowing that God was in their midst. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Any questions so far? Anybody want to ask anything? Any question? Praise the Lord. Number two is praise and worship breaks yokes and brings deliverance. Amen. One of the first things the enemy does when we are facing difficulties, going through our trials, is to play with our mind, as our mind is where the battle is, either won or lost. So the enemy, Satan, puts thoughts in our mind to cause doubts and fear and discouragement. So we don't believe parmeshul, we don't believe the word of God. He will come and play with your mind, tell you that you are worthless, you cannot accomplish this or that, or he will come and remind you of what you are currently facing. He laughs when you focus on your problems, what someone said or did to you, and not upon God, as that is when he can infiltrate your mind and put thoughts in it that will hold you captive. Amen. Just this last slide and we will go to the practical side. That is why the Bible says that the weapons of God are given, has given us, that God has given us, is or not, are not of this world. They are not carnal, weak or powerless, but they are powerful spiritual weapons given to us by God. To do what? Read it for me, 2, 3. Pretension that sets itself. To make it obedient to Christ. Amen. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. There's a shifting going on in this church. There's a shift going on. There's a shift. God is sifting these people. Amen. God is sifting his people. God, do you sift flour here before you do baking? Do you sift flour? Eh? Hallelujah. Why is that? Why do you sift the flour? So if anything that's not supposed to be there, it won't go in the mix. Is that right? Yeah. And this is what Parmeshwar is doing in this church right now. He's sifting us. Amen? He's sifting us. Those who don't want to come under the discipline, hallelujah, of Parmeshwar, he will take them away. He will take them away. Praise the Lord. Amen. Hallelujah. Can we stop there and go to the practical stuff? Is that okay? I will continue with this tomorrow. Hallelujah. Is that okay if I start from here, or do I need to go back and go through some stuff? Speak something. Oh, thank you. Thank you, thank you, thank you so much. Praise the Lord. So here we go. Some practical stuff. So you know the scripture? But you are a chosen generation. Read it. 2, 3. From darkness, out of darkness, into his marvelous light. Few things to consider. We have been specifically chosen by God to worship him. Understand that, eh? We are establishing some truths now, eh? These are absolutes. Amen?
Amen.
We cannot shake it from us. We are an order of royal priesthood before God. We minister to God from a priestly position. Praise the Lord. So as a priest, you speak as a priest, think as a priest, see as a priest, and behave like a priest, and most importantly, dress like a priest.
Look like a priest.
Even though you don't feel like a priest, but at least, you know, dress like one, so everybody will know that's a priest.
Amen.
And do priests go through training? Do they go through training?
Yes.
Thank you. This is your training. You priest, you. We have been made holy through our Savior and Lord Jesus Christ. We are a special people to God. We are peculiar people. We have been given a specific task to do while we are here on planet Earth. To do what? Proclaim God's praises. We cannot proclaim God's praises if we don't praise Him ourselves. Amen. Things to consider if you are a minister of God. See God during the week to prepare for Sunday. Go to the throne yourself before you can lead somebody else there. So can you immerse yourself in the presence of God before you come to minister on Sunday. Praise the Lord. Spend time praying in tongues during the week in your daily devotion. Amen? Spend time praying in tongues. Praise the Lord. How many here you pray in tongues? Okay. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. The scripture is given there in Jude 1 point here. Build up your faith. In your most holy faith, praying in the Holy Spirit. That's the scripture. Praise the Lord. So we're not making it up. Pastor and I, we're not making it up. Amen. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Can you pick on that? Even the shaken hand talking in tongues. So God is given the
Holy Spirit language.
Yeah.
Yeah. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Even Satan can imitate it. Imitate. Copy. They call it counterfeit tongues. Amen. Just like somebody want to copy the $20 note. Amen. Praise the Lord. So Satan is the greatest copycat. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
So counterfeit tongues. I was in a meeting. It was a women's fellowship. They invited me to speak there. I was invited to it, but there was another lady there speaking. And I think she speaks to Jerusalem, and she's got this prayer, you know, there's this Jewish prayer shawl wrapped around her. At the end of the meeting, and she started praying for other ladies. So they come, you know, there was a chair, they sit down, and she started praying, and they were weeping, and, you know, they start praying in tongues. And one lady came. One lady came, sat down. Oh, Jesus. And then started to copy it. And we knew straight away. Praise the Lord. They're thinking that she could imitate like other ladies who are filled with the real thing. Praise the Lord. So that's the kind of thing. You can tell it straight away. Praise the Lord. Especially when you've got the real thing. Praise the Lord. But if you don't have the real thing, Satan came. Hallelujah, does whatever you won't be able to tell. How can you tell the real from the truth if you don't even know the truth? Haven't tasted the truth. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Yeah. We talked about it. Talent, gift, and ability is only 5%. Praise the Lord. Pray in tongues. Get filled with the Holy Ghost. Get filled with the Holy Ghost. Every person, this is our aim. The pastoral team here. Our aim is for every person, every member of this church, is to be filled with the Holy Spirit. Whether you get filled or not depends on you. You have to open yourself to it. Praise the Lord. You have to open yourself to it. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. We can't fill you. Only that's Parmeshwar's job, to fill you. All you can do is prepare the vessel. Keep it clean, keep it ready, and ready to receive it. Amen.
Amen.
Praise the Lord. The dress code. We talked about the dress code. Hallelujah. Especially if you're taking part platform ministry or any kind of ministry in the church. Wear something that won't draw unnecessary attention to yourself. That's why I said it earlier on. No self-promotion. Praise the Lord. No self-promotion. Don't wear clothing that will draw unnecessary attention to yourself. Dress properly. You can wear casual but smart. No see-through or transparent clothing. No sleeveless or thin strap. No mini skirt or cleavage. No t-shirt or polo shirt. Praise the Lord. Don't wear polo shirt up here. Amen. Come on. No board shorts, no three-quarter pants or tights. Somebody asked last night, can we wear sari? Amen, amen. Yeah, praise the Lord. Don't show any skin up here. I know it's your national dress. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Amen. Praise the Lord. Remember, you're a priest. Behavior, conduct, and personal grooming code. No excessive joking or banter with the opposite sex. Amen. This is why pastors fall into adultery. And not only pastors, but even strong Christians. Or they think they're strong. Don't talk to anybody and everybody. Limit your time of talking to the opposite sex. Stay away from it. Especially for pastors. Don't do that. Amen. If you're married, pastor, when you go to pray for a lady, take your wife with you. Don't lock yourself with that woman inside the room somewhere and pray for them. Oh, I went to ministry. Don't ever do that. Hallelujah. Take your wife with you. Eh? If there's anybody to be prayed in the room, he said, wife, go there. Pray for that lady. Praise the Lord. I stand at the door here and I go, praise the Lord. But you pray, wife, over there. Amen. Praise the Lord. These are practical stuff. These are practical stuff. Come on. This will help you. Eh? Hallelujah. If you're unhappy about anything in the church, if you're unhappy about anything, come and notify your leader or your pastor. Praise the Lord. Don't go in correcting other people. Don't go telling other people off. Eh? Sheep don't correct other sheep. Only the shepherd has the authority and the power to correct the sheep. Praise the Lord. Amen. When sheep start correcting sheep, what happens? The pastor comes with a shepherd's rod and dong that sheep. Because that's a troublemaker. Yeah? Dong them in the head to keep them in line. You have no authority to correct any other sheep. Only the shepherd. Power and the authority to do that. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Only the pastor has the authority to take disciplinary action as he or she deemed necessary. Praise the Lord. You don't. There's no revenge in the church. Hallelujah. Yeah? Unforgiveness is the biggest blockage of prayer. If you and I have unforgiveness in our heart, don't expect Parmeshwar to answer our prayer or receive our worship. It's the biggest blockage. Amen.
Amen.
Yeah? Not only that, the longer you maintain unforgiveness in your heart, praise the Lord, now you open the door to the devil to come in and do anything he wants. Yeah? The longer you keep unforgiveness in your heart. I am safe to say here, you come under the curse straight away. Praise the Lord. Amen. Personal hygiene. Brush your teeth. Use perspirant or underarm spray, but don't overdo it. Don't pour the whole bottle on yourself, eh? And you come here, as soon as you get off the roundabout, we can smell you from here. So don't pour it on yourself. Little bit. Especially for us pastors, I think it's safe to carry a breath freshness or mint, especially when we're praying for people in the altar ministry. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Sometimes when we pray for people and pray them in tongues, we speak in their face. Eh? Yeah? Have you been to a meeting like that? When pastors pray for you and they start speaking in your face, especially when they pray in tongues? So that's a proper protocol for it. Here we go. Get up, Brother Joe. Can I demonstrate it? To avoid speaking in his face. So come over there. So he's here. Right? If I get to pray for him, so what I do is that I put my hands here and on the side there speak. So what? So I don't blame him. Yeah? I come back, come and I speak all over his face. Praise the Lord. It happens. So that's why it's very dangerous to sit in the front row. Especially when the pastor comes down here and starts preaching, especially when he's on fire. Yeah, there's somebody's spit coming on you. But it's anointed spit, sister. You take it. Hallelujah. I remember Jesus speaking on somebody's eye, blind, and healed them. Is that right? It's in the Bible? Anointed spit. So if you want anointed spit, come sit in the front row. I'll spit on you. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. So be aware of your time of the month. Women, be aware of your time of the month. Come to church, carry your sanitation stuff, carry spare underwear, sulwatonga, get prepare yourself. Don't get caught out. That's good advice. All the women are going quiet there, see? You don't like it, when a man speaks like that to you, do you? Praise the Lord. But we're dealing with practical stuff. We're dealing with practical stuff. Okay? Don't get caught out. You heard about the example last night, I gave last night. So I'm not going to go through it again. Praise the Lord. The 10 non-negotiable for the praise and worship leader and worship team. Pay attention. You are not the center. Amen. Now I can say this is for the pastor too. Amen. Pastor, you're not the center. Make Jesus the center. Make Jesus the center. Preach about Jesus. Teach about Jesus. Lead people to Jesus. Make Jesus the focus of everything that we do. Amen? Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Your priority is helping the congregation sing with faith. Yeah? The pastor's priority is to help the people grow in faith, strong in faith. Amen.
Amen.
Yeah? Number four, support your pastor. No, nobody said amen to that, pastor. Say
amen. Amen.
But nobody wants to support us.
Amen.
Praise the Lord. I guess we got nobody else to rely on except Jesus. You choose songs that are full of truth. Choose songs that are full of truth. Don't choose songs that are just full of fancy words. We don't want fancy words. We want truth. Yeah? We want Bible. We want scripture in the songs. Choose them. Sing them. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Use musicians who are gifted and have soft hearts towards Jesus. Use people up here on the platform. Use people in the ministry. Yeah, that are gifted, but have a soft heart. So in other words, if somebody's a little bit hard, give them time to develop. Don't use them too early. Because pride can rise up. They think they're somebody when they're nobody. And the people say,
amen.
You tailor the keys. This is the song keys, eh? Not the key to open the door. And arrangements of songs to serve the people in the room, to serve your congregations. Eh? Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Your family come first. Praise the Lord. Don't spend too much time in church and neglect your family. Praise the Lord. Your family will suffer. Like Eli and Samuel. They both went down the same thing. Great men of God, are terrible parents. Amen. Learn the lesson from those two great prophets, and they will profit of a nation, not just a small church. Amen. You are never alone with someone of the opposite sex who isn't your spouse. That's for us all leadership and also the church. Eh? Never spend time alone, too much time, or even just time with someone of the opposite sex who is not your spouse. Praise the Lord. And you never, never, never compromise Numbers 1 to 9. We all clear on that, eh? MC, the master of ceremony, when he steps up on the, when he or she steps up on the platform, the whole music team over here submit to that leadership. The changes in the song and the repeat of the song is now up to the MC, not the musicians. Praise the Lord. Eh? So you guys should be paying attention to him or her. Praise the Lord. I've noticed several times in this church, huh? Hallelujah, the music team just do whatever they want to. Amen. So pay attention, music team. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
The worship leaders and the worship team's creed. Let's also make this our creed. Yeah, a creed is like a motto. Amen. Hallelujah. It's like our core values are included in it. Eh? This is what we believe and this is what we do. Amen. Let's read it together. Number one, two, three. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. So when we yield, praise the Lord, when we yield, that gifting, that talent, that ability needs to be yielded to the Holy Spirit of God when we come to minister, eh? Whatever service we're ministering in, eh? Whether it's morning service, evening service, crusade, whatever. Praise the Lord. Yield it to the Holy Spirit. Hallelujah. We don't use the Holy Spirit. The Holy Spirit uses us. Amen. Amen. Yeah? I believe that when I offer my ego and dreams to the purposes of Christ, I will find His character more fully formed in me and His dreams more fully realized through me. You notice there is a submission of our personality, eh? To the Holy Spirit. Yeah? There is a submission to the Holy Spirit. We don't do whatever we want to do. We don't sing what we want to sing. We don't preach what we just want to preach. We don't try to impress people. Amen? We don't try to impress people. We are not people pleasers. Praise the Lord. We are not people pleasers. Amen? Hallelujah. We'd rather be hated by people but loved by God.
Amen?
Amen? Because when everything else falls apart, the only person that will uphold us and sustain us is Parmeshwar. When everybody else leaves the church and there's nobody else here except the pastors, and we've got nobody else to rely on and depend on except Parmeshwar. Hallelujah. Because He's the one that called us, not the people. Amen. I believe that when I attended to the details in the lives of those given to my care, beginning with my spouse and family, the Father will take care of the details of my own life. Amen. Praise the Lord. That's just talking about sacrifice, eh? Peter said that, eh? We've left all and come and follow you. Praise the Lord. Jesus said you'll be blessed here in this life and even more in the eternal life. Amen. I believe that a life of worship is the most meaningful activity in which a human can participate, and I embrace my role as an encourager of this activity in any gathered worship, a setting into which the Holy Spirit invites me. Praise the Lord. We are encouragers of people to worship Parameshwar. Amen? Hallelujah. Encouragers, we facilitate. Yeah? We provide it. We make it available so people can come, yeah? And worship Parameshwar. Amen? Praise the Lord. Any question? Praise the Lord. Time is catching up very quickly. I believe that every act of creativity and each effort to express that creativity beautifully with the goal of worship in mind will end in fruitful transformation in the lives of those I lead. So what happens is that when we begin to worship Parameshwar in spirit and truth, lives are changed and transformed in the presence of God. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Because that's the only place where lives can be changed, in the presence of God. And that's where we need to get to, when we do praise and worship on Sunday or every service we go to it. We need to get to the presence. We need to get from the outer court into the Holy of Holies. Praise the Lord. And that's where the praise and worship team comes in. Because you're leading the church, you need to bring us through the gate, into the outer court, into the inner court, into the Holy of Holies. Praise the Lord. We all have a big job to do it. But we can do it. So we prepare our lives for that. We prepare our lives to meet with God, hallelujah, every time we come to worship. That's why the tabernacle is called the tent of meeting. Parameshwar come to meet his people come to meet with Parameshwar.
Can we say that we are still in outer court when we don't worship and praise like we want to depend on just someone who does everything for us?
Yeah.
It shows that we are still on the outer court.
Yes.
We have not entered in the inner court yet.
That's true. That is true. That is true. This is why I say this. Let me say this, since he's saying the question here, is that don't wait to come on Sunday morning to go to the throne. Okay? You do that on your own. You prepare yourself before you come to church to go to the throne. Praise the Lord. And you see this. You see different churches you go to, you see this, you watch. Some people, as soon as the praising or the worship starts, bang, they are engaged straight away. Why? You can tell because they've been preparing all weekend. Yeah? And you can also tell with the praise and worship team. You can notice with the praise and worship team who has prepared themselves, who has been to the throne during the week, and not use that service to be an avenue for them to go to the throne. Yeah? Because they can stand up here and never go to the Holy of Holies themselves. They remain in the outer court. I'm talking about praise and worship team. Huh? How are you going to take us into the Holy of Holies when you're still in the outer court? Praise and worship team? Amen. Praise the Lord. We cannot lead somebody else to the throne if we haven't been there. Good question. Anybody else? Praise the Lord. Number 6. I believe that Jesus is leading us all home to himself, and that the privilege of leading worship is to inspire hope, courage, joy, and mission in each soul on that ultimate journey. Amen? Hallelujah. You understand something? When we get to heaven, we will do nothing except worship. If we cannot do it down here, we will learn it up there. You'll have to start from kindergarten again. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. But if you don't learn it up here, you'll miss so much. We will miss so much. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Here's another one, practical. For the leadership team, take the time to debrief the whole service a couple of days after. Debrief it. Hallelujah. Whether it'll be on a Monday night or Tuesday night, Yeah? Bring your leadership. The leader of the praise and worship team, praise the Lord, children's church, youth, yeah? Hallelujah. Secretary, treasurer, amen, hallelujah. And let's pull the service apart, section by section. Praise the Lord. Don't leave it too long, eh? Don't say, oh, we will do it on Friday, because you have Sunday to prepare for during the week. So I said, within those first 2 days, eh? Excuse me. And the Monday or Tuesday, praise the Lord, look for ways of how we can improve ourselves and the task allocated to us. Few questions that need to be asked. Did the Holy Spirit show up during the service? Any salvation, healing, breakthrough, answered prayers, etc. Was there a flow in the service? Amen? How was the preaching? How much is substance and how much is story? So we really pulling it apart. Amen? Hallelujah. It should be 70%. Yeah? It should be 70% substance and 30% story or illustration. Yeah? Praise the Lord. Some preachers let this go for 80%. Yeah? Of substance. Yeah? So you know they really waited before God and prepared and bent. Yeah? So the people that are preaching on 90% substance, you know you're getting meat, eh? Right from the introduction, eh? To the conclusion. You're just eating. Huh? Hallelujah. Steak all the way. Praise the Lord. Amen? Yeah, my brother. Yeah.
So could you explain to them, those who don't know how to accept the Holy Spirit?
Yeah. This is why we need to organize a prayer chain. Terry night meeting. Praise the Lord.
Yeah.
We come and pray. Yeah, when praise and worship team finish the rehearsal here, praise the Lord. Yeah. Hallelujah. Turn off all these lights, only that light on. Hallelujah. When we pray all night here. All night. This altar, not to remain empty. So we design it every hour, there's a change. Praise the Lord. Yeah. So if two people come pray, 9 to 10. Yeah. So 10 to 10, two more people come. And then the 10 to 11, two more people. Right? 10 to 12, two more people. So the prayer chain doesn't break. It continues all night seeking the Holy Ghost. Praise the Lord. I guarantee you will get filled. How do I know? Because that's what happened to me. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. We need to get serious with God. Eh? We need to get serious with God. Get desperate for God. Are you all night? Are people going to wait? So if you want to do ministry, if you want to get involved, if you want to be a true worshiper of God, get filled with the Holy Ghost. Get filled with the Holy Ghost. I don't know any other way of saying it. Get filled with the Holy Ghost. Praise the Lord. Any question? Thank you, Brother Sandeep. Any question? Let's all stay at this. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Wonderful Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Just say a word of thank you to Parameshwar. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Oh, wonderful God, we worship you. Wonderful God, we worship you. We thank you, Lord God. Hallelujah. For preparing us. We thank you, God. Hallelujah. For setting us up for something bigger, something greater. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Lord God, thank you, God. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Hallelujah. Pastor Tish, can you say a word of prayer to close our meeting tonight? In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Just say to somebody, shake their hands, say hello to them, praise the Lord. Hallelujah. You may be seated. Hallelujah.